L'Organisation des Nations
Unies pour l'éducation, la culture,
At Hotel Gasser number 10, where Bern's smart set now dance the night away under strobe lights, the Hôtel de Musique opened its doors in 1770. A group of young men from Bernese patrician families who'd served in the Dutch army wanted to add some joie de vivre to their Protestant city. They built their club, a hall for receptions, music and dancing, in the style of the Dutch social clubs they'd visited. The conservative city fathers in the town council, however, opposed their theatre project. As a result, the Grande Société de Berne had a theatre, but could not stage plays for almost three decades. The Puritan regime held sway until French troops occupied the Swiss Confederation at the end of the 18th century, when plays were finally performed on a regular basis and the theatre earned its popular nicknames of du théâtre or dudu, which are used to this day. For the next 100 years, it was Bern's municipal theatre. The tradition of using the bel étage of the Cercle de la Grande Société for cultural, political and social gatherings has been kept alive for centuries. State visitors, politicians, business leaders and private parties are still waited on with discretion at the bel étage. This venerable institution also houses the Lorenzini, one of the most famous bars in Bern. When the Hôtel de Musique was built by architect Niklaus Sprüngli, it sparked a rift between lovers of popular culture and defenders of high culture. But over the centuries, it succeeded in adapting to the zeitgeist. Today, the Hôtel de Musique is a meeting point for social life, culture and culinary excellence, and the vibrant centre of Bern's self-assured party scene.